Hello friends, so today's video is a very interesting one because we have gotten one step more closer to the superbike purchase. So I have kind of made my mind to look for a Triumph Street Triple because that is something that I'm looking at. We haven't made the money to buy a Triumph Street Triple as of now, but that is one of the bike in my mind. It's not a liter class bike because people, when you say super bike, people think about liter class, but it's an amazing machine because I've had a chance to ride Street Triple, the old one. So maybe we will most likely go for the new one. So that is something that we have planned. So regarding the spares, all the spares which I could sell have been sold. There are a couple of things which are left and I'm not going to touch it, like the RD350 mask. I have decided not to let that go. So we sold the Continental GT mudguard, the RD350 mudguard, to subscribers, and it looks like they are pretty happy with their purchase. But we have to see, you know, once they fix this on their bike, if they're still as happy as, you know, they were when they purchased it, then it is going to be a win-win. Also, I have bought two RXZ chassis, like things which require a little bit of work, like not something which is immediately sellable. Like one has some welding which has been done, so it's a botched up welding, like, you know, they had the footrest welded to the chassis itself. So those kind of things we are getting fixed. Other chassis is pretty awesome because there was absolutely least amount of work in that, and the seller actually sold it to me for around 1800 rupees shipped. So that was a great deal. So now what we are going to do is that also requires some bit of fixing, patch up, small stuff, like, you know, the place where the center stand mounts, it is slightly oval because of usage, so we'll have to fix that as well. And then properly we'll get this powder coated. I'll have the chassis number taken out from there and properly powder coated so that it looks like a brand new chassis. So when it is going to leave us, it is going to look as good as new. So that is one plan. So two of those is what I bought. So both of them we got for a good deal. Like one I got in exchange for a Shogun silencer from a subscriber. That is the one which has the footrest and all welded to the chassis. So it was not useful to him, but then, you know, we can definitely make use of that. So that's it. I'm not going to sell any more spares as of now. But then I have committed the chain cover to one of the subscribers which is still with me. So we will probably go ahead and let that go. And also there is a discussion with another subscriber for, I have actually the last model headlight, I actually don't know what to call it. It is the headlight stay, actually. So the last model headlight stay is requested by a subscriber. I actually have it here, I'll show you in a minute. So the headlight stay might get exchanged, the headlight stay and the RD350 aftermarket seat trim might get exchanged for an RX100 fourth oversized cylinder, unsleeved. So if that happens, that will also come to market pretty soon. So we'll have to see about that. Another thing is, yesterday when these subscribers came, I actually was at the workshop where I get my cruise service, so I decided to meet them there because it is convenient for them also. Otherwise, coming all the way here is not possible. So when we met there, there is a junkyard right next to that place, so we just had a quick recon mission inside the junkyard and we could purchase some more amazing stuff. I actually got an original heavy gauge RX100 carrier, and I also got a RX100 Alfa Tauyo tail light, which was free. So the tail light I just fixed into my RX100. I'll show you that. The headlights, I mean the carrier actually has one of the tabs missing, so that is given for repair. It's actually in pretty decent condition, like still has the original chrome, but I don't think we can buff it out. Let's see, you know, once we get it from the welding workshop, we can take a look. If you know we can buff it out and make it look reasonably presentable, then we will we might let it go as is. Then I also, you know, then after that I went for another junkyard hunt, which was on the way. So there was a Libero lying there, but which had almost everything taken off from it. So it was just bare chassis, front forks, and couple of stuff. So what I did is I actually bought the top part of the handle. So my plan was to get the headlight stay as well, because that is the headlight that came into the last model. But you know, I kind of thought it's okay, let's not get it, because it was slightly rusted, so I didn't want to spend more money than what I actually bought it for. So if I do a couple of more junkyard trips, then probably I might get some more stuff. So that is planned. Like, you know, I'm going to do this junkyard trips couple of weeks, you know, going forward. Some people might have you know, things against the British brand Triumph, but I actually like it because you know, I've ridden most of their bikes. Actually, I test drove one of their Daytonas, which actually crashed the very next day when the test drive guys were going back, and I was kind of sold to buy Street Triple at that time. But then I, after this accident happened, I kind of stepped back, because you know, I'm not a rider, to be honest. You know, my experience in riding is mostly the RX100 and the RD350, nothing more than that. So it is kind of going to be risky. And then something tragic happened last year. One of my friends, my best friend's cousin, actually passed away in a accident in his Kawasaki Z900. So my friend kind of, you know, made me take a blood oath that, you know, I'm not going to buy a super bike. So that is another reason why, you know, the super bike purchase got delayed every, you know, couple of days, I mean couple of years. So the plan, you know, another friend and I kind of decided in 2016 that 2020 is when we are going to buy a super bike. But you know, you guys know how shitty or how horrible this year is. So we are seeing unprecedented things in this 1 year. So super bike is definitely not going to happen anytime soon. But if I can convince myself to buy super bikes by flipping these you know, parts that I buy, then one thing is Home Minister won't be angry. Second thing is I will also have some peace of mind, because I'm not buying something in EMIs, I'm actually buying something with full cash. So that is gonna definitely help me. But then at the same time, this, you know, whole experiment was done for a few subscribers who always used to comment that, you know, they do not have the money. See, I am from a middle class family, and middle class families have this major issue of, you know, budgeting and cash crunch. So if you plan something little, you know, badly, your whole budget can go bad. So at that time we decided that we will buy a super bike definitely at some point in time. But then I kind of thought that it is not a good idea right now, because I don't want to take an EMI. But since I'm turning 40 in a year, and plus, you know, my midlife crisis officially gets kicked in, so I have to buy something. So that is the reason why, that was also one of the inspiration in starting the series. So far the series is going well, and I have two advantages which you guys might not have. One is, you know, I have been doing this for some time. Like, you know, I fix my bikes, so I go to various junkyards, and I love spending time in junkyards. So that is one thing that I consider myself to be good at. Then second thing, which is because of you guys, like you know, since I have this YouTube channel, a lot of people, you know, actually have reached out to me and told me that, you know, they have this stuff, they have that stuff for sale. So that gave me another idea. So that idea is we might organize a parts jumble, like, you know, we have a good subscriber base now. So if we can all probably, you know, start something somewhere here in Trivandrum first, wherein most of our subscribers will be called if they want to buy bikes. You know, subscribers can sell their bikes to other subscribers, then there will be other people coming in. So once the COVID vaccination is out, then we will plan that. So that is going to be definitely helpful, because a lot of people have a lot of spares which they do not need. And two things: one is they don't like, you know, to sell it to somebody, because they kind of don't want to do it because of the hassle, like, you know, it is just 100, 200 bucks worth of spares. Like, you know, to give you an example, the RX 100 seat ring, those kind of stuff. So a parts jumble can definitely help them. So that is also planned. So let's see how things go. So I'll just show you a couple of things that I got yesterday for a couple of hundred bucks. So one is the carrier, which is already at the welding workshop getting repaired. But I also got some more stuff, so I'll show you guys those things as well. And plus, I'll give you an update of the things that you can see in the background. Okay, so yeah, let's do that. So we'll start with the tail light. So as you can see, this is an original Alpha Toyo tail light. I got the entire tail light, but I just changed the glass because the rest of the thing is brand new, so I didn't want to spend a lot of time there. Plus, we got a similar carrier like this. This is not an original carrier, this is an aftermarket carrier, but the one that we got is an original carrier, so that is an advantage. Then moving on to here, we actually bought this top end part of a Libero. So a couple of good things that we got along with that is, one is that meter, which is definitely a positive, because that looks like an RD400 meter. So I'm going to change the meter case and probably reuse what is inside. So this is a cable driven one that has a taco. So this taco is actually a pretty good one, to be honest. So let's plan to put this in the big bore build. Then we have this switch gear, which is also an awesome thing, because this itself brand new costs around 600, and this is in a pretty decent condition. This thing is useful, because last week also, you know, we were struggling to find this, as well as the, you know, the throttle linkage. Plus, the good thing that we have is we got this plate, so this can be used in a last model bike, so we probably might let that go. I like the handle, it is pretty wide, and it's actually a reasonable handle, so probably might use that for some project. So yeah, that was one score. I paid 100 rupees for the entire deal, so that was definitely a good purchase. Okay, so moving on here, I actually am fighting a demon in this bike, because the carburetor from this bike is from my friend's Tiger. So that's a 4-speed bike. So you already saw that we replaced the master cylinder on this. So next thing what we need to do is we need to top this up, so that I have to go to a shop and get some brake fluid. Then I changed the silencer to this, because that silencer actually is robbing a lot of power. And then I also changed the screws to Allen keys, and that is kind of a work in progress, so that we will talk about. So the demon that I'm fighting here is the choke is getting pulled always, and you know, it's kind of getting, like the word choke, it is getting choked. So there is no fuel coming in other than the choke circuit. So we'll have to figure that out. I'm actually trying to fix it, but the challenge is I don't know the cable routing for a RxZ. So we'll have to figure that out. We'll do that. So next one is the RD350. As you know, the smut guard has to go for plating. So my friend who owns the orange RD is going to come today, hopefully with new silencers, and we'll buy those silencers from him if they are good, and then give these for plating. Or if they are not that great, then temporarily use those on this bike and give the ones on this bike for plating. The next demon that I'm fighting is this. So the thread is kind of little shorter, so we will have to fix that. So I'm going to do that now after I wrap up this video. Then, like I said, RX100, we changed the tail light. So slowly things are getting original. The other silencer that I had planned to sell, I'm not going to. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get that silencer fixed properly and get that plated, because that is the one that came with this bike. So this silencer that you see might come up for sale pretty soon. Recently plated, very good condition. Couple of dings here. So that was given to the shop to fix, but that guy didn't. So probably that is going to stay, but otherwise overall it looks great. It's a 6-hole silencer again. Sounds pretty awesome. I just have to show you guys how it sounds. So I'll have to install a kill switch, because after I got these new keys cut for it, it is not working. The ignition key doesn't stop it. So I'll have to see what is the problem, because we have the same problem on my friend's bike as well. So we might have to do some bit of ingenious work in this. So the easiest thing is to install a kill switch and connect it to the main wiring, and that way we can turn it off. Otherwise this key is working everywhere. I can open the tank, I can lock the bike, like, you know, see, it is locked. But the only thing is something has happened in the ignition barrel, so we'll have to check what is happening. Okay, so I think that's it.